Welcome to Yung Tuition. Today is 14 September 2023. Let's continue discussing basic issues in physics. Can we prove the rise of the near surface air temperature is man-made? One person on this planet said he can and has done it. Who is he? Yes. Klaus Hasselmann, the founding director of Max Planck Institute for Meteorology. In 2021, he shared the Nobel Prize in Physics with Manabe and a theorist in physics. Today, I'm going to talk about him and his relevant work called Stochastic Climax Model. Please like, make a comment, the more the better, and subscribe. I hope YouTube algorithm would work in favor of humanity this time. So, are you ready? Let's go, have fun. Based on Hasselmann's biography, he was trained and worked as an oceanographer in the 60s and early 70s. He also wrote quantum field-like papers on ocean wave scattering with the Feynman diagrams. According to the Nobel Prize Committee, he had provided the relationship between weather and climate, developed the fingerprinting methods to assess the human impact on Earth's climate. Sounds very important, isn't it? To my surprise, as I have found, his fingerprinting method is not based on physics, but inferential statistics, such as the central limit theorem and the confidence interval that are taught in the high school. How did he do that? The question is. Well, before I answer this question, let's talk about Fourier again. It is known that any time-dependent variations, which form a time series, can be mathematically transformed into the so-called power spectral density, PSD, or power spectrum. This transformation was introduced by Fourier, who also speculated that the atmosphere could keep the surface warm. In this diagram, time series and their frequency spectra of several musical instruments are shown. In this way, the color of sound can be easily identified. Hence, one can call such frequency spectra as the fingerprint, similar to how DNA base pair sequences for characterizing genes. Not only did Hasselmann know this spectral analysis quite well, but also he had a crazy idea. Namely, he wanted to use the Fourier transformation to prove that global warming is man-made or anthropogenic without using physics. In 1976, as Chairman Mao was dying, Hasselmann published his idea that slow climate change can be treated as a cumulative response to continuous random excitation by short time scale weather disturbance, such as the Brownian motion. Do you know the Brownian motion? In 1905, Einstein first derived a formula based on molecular motion for random movements of the tiny pollen particles suspended in a fluid, first observed by a botanist, Brown, in 1827. The random walks of the particles can either be described by stochastic trajectories or deterministic evolution of probability density function. In this 3D diagram I generated based on Einstein's original formula, you can see how probability distribution change with time. Notice that the observable Brownian motion is caused by random molecular collisions, but the causality between climate and weather proposed by Hasselmann is merely hypothetical. Namely, CO2 can make the surface warmer by radiative forcing, or the gas night, as one viewer called it. Where did he get this hypothesis? You may wonder, as I did in 2021, after I heard the news. Remember, as I mentioned before, Hasselmann had studied ocean waves for many years before he became a climate activist. As early as 1962, he reported that certain resonant coupling between random ocean waves could make non-linear energy transfer, which are visible in the Fourier transformed spectrum, like this one. I think that was why he came up with the assumption that two distinct peaks exist in the Fourier transformed spectra of the time series of stochastic weather changes. The high frequency noises associated with weather and the low frequency or red signal associated with climate. Contrary to Hasselmann's assumption, however, almost everyone in this research field knows today the Fourier transformed power distribution from both the instrumental data and that inferred from ice cores, from time scale from few days to 1 million years, are continuous, as shown in this figure. So let's see how this Nobel physics laureate responded cunningly.
In your renowned paper about stochastic climate models, and also in other papers, you use as basic assumption the timescale separation between fast and slow variables. Now, we had in the seminar series a talk given by Sean Lovejoy, who was saying that there is no timescale separation in the climate system. There are no characteristic timescales. And instead of a spectral gap, there is a spectral continuum. So what do you think now about the assumption of timescale separation?
I think it's a question of vocabulary. I don't think anything has changed in the past in that respect. We always do have the slow changes in the climate system and fast changes in the climate system, and the fact that these are coupled is also well established, so that we do have a coupling between different timescales. I think what was particularly new in the work that I was doing at that time was that this timescale separation went across very large timescale separations. In other words, the changes in weather from hour to hour or day to day could trigger a very long-term changes in the climate system, that you have a coupling between the high frequencies of the climate of the weather system and the low frequencies of the climate system. And this is something which is sort of trivial nowadays. I think that we would
Did you hear that? He repeatedly used the word coupling. That is because he believed the two random variables are not only correlated or coupled, but also their spectral amplitudes must be physically interacted, or in vocabulary of quantum mechanics, entangled. which could describe by this weird equation with a singularity at zero frequency. But this equation is incorrect because, to my knowledge, the general form of spectral power density is written by both frequency and coronation time, as you can find in Ridford's books on relaxation in magnetic resonance. Also, it should be made clear that the coronation functions in his theory can merely derived from finite time series generated by climate model simulations. In other words, no coronation function in Hasselmann's climate theory can be derived from basic law in physics, because his coupling and energy transfer is, by and large, virtual or imaginary. Yes, like Andersen's Emperor's New Clothes. By way of contrast, all of the coronation functions used in physics, both autocoronation and cross-coronation, are directly derived from the basic and identifiable interactions, such as magnetic couplings in my early research field, magnetic resonance, and dynamical nuclear polarization transfer called DNP. That can be calculated from the spin Hamiltonian. I will discuss this issue in detail for specialists. He argued that the amplitude of slow but periodical change in climate variables in terms of cumulative random fluctuation in short-term weather changes. Instead, it should be other way around, namely, the weather patterns and their variations are governed by the climate states of the Earth. What do you think? It seems very sad nowadays that some traditional research methods in physics have been overwhelmingly replaced by inferential statistics, such as recent reports and rewards on the standard model, gravitational waves, and black holes, as I have discussed in my talks before. Please have a look if you're interested. It would appear some so-called physicists wish to go beyond humans' capability. They created abstract concepts and formulas and built their statistical confidence to mislead the public in order to gain their research fund and personal fame. Ironically, so many people are willing to be fooled by them. C'est la vie, c'est notre monde.
The award came as a complete surprise to me. It is mainly in recognition of work I did some 15 years ago, when I estimated that the probability that the global warming we had been experiencing in the last century could be attributed to natural climate variability was less than about 5%.
In fact, his 95% statistical confidence was backed by his assumption and computer simulations, not real experimental or instrumental observations. This is not physics at all. So why should we trust Hasselmann's claim that he has successfully proven that global warming is caused by man-made CO2? Just as I was about to give this talk, when I came to realize what is wrong in Hasselmann's theory. In short, the origin can be traced back to his early idea about so-called non-linear energy transfer between ocean waves based on energy conservation law. He wrote several papers on this issue. as shown in this figure, one low frequency peak increases as another higher frequency peak decreases in this power spectrum. But it is unlikely such energy transfer could occur in an open-endedness sea where energy conservation law is invalid. So it could be argued that Hasselmann might have thought such a localized effect could be used to describe the climate change by analogy of his energy transfer as a cumulative random weather fluctuations. Nevertheless, the global warming caused by CO2-induced forcing remains as a hypothesis. No one could prove Hasselmann's claim is right without assuming his analysis is reliable in the first place. I hope this short introduction is not too abstract. At least you know now a truly stochastic model should be built based on physics. But Hasselmann's stochastic climate model is not a climate model at all, but a well-disguised inferential method. In short, Hasselmann's argument is by no means hassle-free. To know what I mean, please read this paper written by his team. Meanwhile, please stay tuned. Thank you for viewing. Please subscribe. See you next time.